Another dimension is what I've been calling the quality school development group. And it really, again, I think for me, I want to build on the extraordinary and thoughtful work that's gone before me and before us. And there's a history here. There are people who have learned lessons about how to organize, how to create new small schools, how to create better learning environments for kids, how to create public nonprofits, whether it's the Museum of Children's Art, places for children to be engaged, thoughtful, and creative, that change not just the kids' experience, but change the community's experience around children. We have to learn from folks who are in our community. And so for me, this quality school development group idea is bring the strands together that have both been inside the organization and out. Create a citywide campaign around what does good look like, and then have an engine inside the district that, much like the charter review process that some of you have gone through, that raises the standard, is clear about what the expectations are. And we bring that inside the district, but then we have a practice sharing database, we have an expectation about what good looks like, we have a constant review process. That has to be the core of this. So what that exactly looks like and how we design it, that's gonna be for me, there's gonna be some stuff I put out as features that are non-negotiable. And the other stuff that I'm not smart enough or experienced enough to create the whole thing. So we're gonna do that together, but that's gonna be coming. The other thing that I think you should probably know is that I am kind of, my pedagogy, where I think about the relationship of teacher to child, Henry Giroux writes about liberatory pedagogy and liberatory practice. I think as we frame our future, we are not talking simply about doing better and teaching kids and getting them smarter. We have to be working in a liberatory framework. So as I move forward and think about the way we can talk about our academics, I'll be talking about learning and liberation. And how I frame that and what that looks like is still in motion. But we have to get past an idea of literacy as a static function. Our literacies are now cross-cultural, they're multi-literate. We have to know and understand changing contexts. We have to have a kind of cross-cultural competence that's changing all the time. This idea of liberation has to be embedded in our practice, but it has to be first, I think, live centrally in the message. So those are some of the features of what will come forward, but it has to be in the context of caring for, nurturing, and just, helping children blossom and bloom. This idea of the whole child can't be great for pre-K, and it can't, well, kindergartens are wonderful for that, but then we gotta get them ready for the tests. You know what, we have to think different about how we care for, nurture the learning environment. This might sound good here because of go, but I think we have to talk about the finishing and the going. We have to create a downward looking into the system. We want all of our children to finish a high quality education that prepares them for success. And then we have to escort them, nurture them, and support them to go into positive futures. And in my mind, Oakland can be a place that does that. We have so many resources, so many assets, and people who care with all their hearts, and they bring tremendous talent to the table. So, you know, I come here tonight just more fired up than ever, quite frankly. And, you know, there are huge cuts, they're hard, and people ask me, how can you do it? If I didn't believe in us, if I didn't believe in our capacity and ability to do it, I would be pretty down. However, kids are gonna keep coming. We have public schools, and if we don't prepare kids, the kids who will not get prepared are kids that we can, unfortunately, predict and know. The effect of inequity accumulates over generations, folks, and over institutions. And if we continue to gut our public institutions that care most for kids in high need, we will see a bifurcated society. We will see a destruction of democracy that I hope to see. And I am here with a pretty extraordinary belief in us to accomplish it, to get to a vision of a healthy Oakland that we all share and contribute to. So thank you, and I'll take questions.